Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica Rally here. Now here I have my, the glass needs to be cleaned a little bit, but I still determined to make this video because of several issues in which I have to deal with after this. Now here is my koi in which I purchased a few months ago, in which I said that I would watch it grow. I had one inside and one outside. I ended up releasing about 80% of the water for my pond outside, just to actually size up the fish to see whether or not any difference have been made with regards to the size between both one inside and one outside. I know that I should have actually caught it and actually showed it on camera. I'm gonna see if I can do that in a bit. I'm not gonna try to catch it because trust me, it's a lot of work just to catch this one fish in a 250 gallon tote outside. All right, but one thing I can say about this fish right here, yes, the glass is messy, but look beyond that. Now this fish is in a tank with some corys. Corys are nocturnal. I noticed the other day when I was checking on my fish, because this is a habit of mine, I usually check on them, just sit and watch them, look at them to see if there is any, you know, abnormalities. I realized that some scales are missing at the side of this fish, which is my koi, right? So it just leads me to think that since the corys are nocturnal and I know that they will eat any single fry or nibble on any single slime that exists on any fish within the tank, pond, or wherever it is my suspicion that at night the corys are actually playing around with the koi as it sleeps. Yes, fish do sleep. So as a result, I will be practically removing the koi from this tank and I'll be placing it somewhere else. I'll be placing this koi right in this tank. And I'll be removing the cichlid fries, the white convict cichlid fries, and I'll share with you why in a bit. Thank you very much for making it Fish Keeping Jamaica. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. Do have a wonderful day.